Hi, hello everybody, welcome to you, welcome again in Bioscience Mania. And now in today's video we discuss about floral formula. So first of all, we know about what is floral formula. The floral formula is a symbolic expression of members of floral whole. Okay, we know four floral whole present in a flower. Okay, this is known as calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. So this is the expression, symbolic expression of four floral whole, okay, in which their number, cohesion or adhesion position and the position of ovary can summarize. Means we know about the number of calyx or corolla, androecium, gynoecium and cohesion nature or adhesion nature of the floral formula and position of ovary can summarize. Okay, but few things that are not known from the floral formula. These are nature of aestivation, placentation, position of floral members with respect to mother axis. This three things are not known from the floral formula. Okay, so I hope this is. And now next we know about all the symbols and their structure and their specific name. Okay, so don't waste any time, let's start.
So first of all, we know about symbol. Okay, symbols. Okay, so first of all, this is indicate the male flower. This is indicate male flower. Okay, this is indicate male flower. This symbol indicate female flower. Female flower. Okay, and this symbol where male and female both are present, this is called bisexual flower. Okay, next we use actinomorphic or zygomorphic. What is actinomorphic? We already discussed when we discuss about types of flower. So there we already discussed actinomorphic, but here I want to take a short definition. Actinomorphic means when you cut a flower into two equal half through any of the direction. Okay, and zygomorphic, so this is the symbol of actinomorphic. Okay, actinomorphic flower. And next we talk about zygomorphic. Sometime symbolized by this, or sometime it symbolized by this. Okay, so this is zygomorphic flower. So what is zygomorphic flower? Basically, when you cannot cut a flower into two equal half through any of the vertical plane or through any of the position, so this is called zygomorphic flower. Okay, now next we talk about calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. First of all, we talk about calyx. Calyx indicated by K. So you know about that calyx is the one of the outermost floral hole. Okay, so calyx indicate by K. This is calyx. Okay, this is calyx. And when calyx indicate 5, it means calyx contain 5, means calyx, the unit membrane of calyx is called sepal. Okay, sepal. And when 5 sepal present, then it is called sepals 5, and this is indicated by this symbol. Okay, K5. Okay, next, if the number 5 under first bracket, then the calyx sepals are 5. Okay, sepals are 5, but here the sepal are free, that's the reason here no bracket present. And here the sepals are united, means attached with one another. So that's the reason it is called it is united. Okay, so that's the reason the free sepal is called polysepalus. Okay, and here the sepal is united, and that is the reason it is called gamosepalus. Okay, next we talk about corolla. Okay, corolla indicate by C. This is corolla. Okay, this is corolla. and when corolla means petal, the unit member of corolla is called petal. Okay, petal. Okay, when corolla indicate 5 at the base without bracket, then it is called corolla or petal. Petals are 5. Okay, but the petals are free. Okay, that's the reason it is called polypetalous. Polypetalous. Okay, next, if the petal are united, this indicate by bracket. Okay, like calyx. What is happen in case of calyx? That same thing happen in case of corolla. Okay, and here the corolla petals simplify. Okay, simplify, but here the petal is called gamopetalous. Okay, this is called gamopetalous. Okay, so here P indicate perianth. Okay, what is perianth? Basically perianth is the unit structure of a calyx and corolla. Basically when calyx and corolla fuse and form a single structure, then it is called perianth. Okay, so perianth also bear 5 or more than 5 or less than 5 perianth, and the unit member of perianth is called tepal. Okay, tepal. So tepals are 5 here, but here these are free, polytepalous. Okay, polytepalous. And the same thing happened when perianth 5, but they are united, they are bracket under first bracket, then we call perianth tepals 5, but they are gamotepalous. Okay, gamotepalous. Okay, next, so this is calyx, corolla and perianth already complete, and next we discuss about the most vital and the third and fourth floral hole. This is called androecium and gynoecium. Okay, so first of all we discuss about androecium. Basically androecium indicated by A. Okay, androecium. So the unit member of androecium is called stamen. Okay, so in androecium, multiple number of stamen, it is indicated by this sign, infinitive sign. Okay, so then this androecium or stamen is numerous, means multiple number of androecium is present, then it is called monoecious. Okay, monoecious. So then it is called monoecious. Okay, next, when androecium is divided into two structure or two form, like 9:1, then it is called dioecious. Okay, then it is called dioecious. And the same thing happened when androecium present 2+2 structure, like 2 are large and 2 are small. So this then the androecium is called didynamous. Okay, stamen is also called, it is called didynamous. Okay, same thing happened when the androecium present 6, but 4 are large and 2 are small, or 4 are large or long and 2 are small, then it is called tetradynamous. Okay, because here 4, tetra means 4, so 4 are long, that's the reason it is called tetradynamous. Okay, so now here complete the androecium, but sometimes androecium attach with the outer floral membrane or inner floral membrane. Okay, like when the androecium attach with outer floral member like calyx or perianth. Okay, when they are attached with calyx, then it is symbolized by C. Calyx always indicated by C and androecium indicated by A, and it is attached. Because of this is attached, that the reason it is presented by the underline over the C and A. Okay, sometimes it always indicated by C or A through this structure. Okay, through this symbol. So it means this is androecium attached with calyx. Okay, androecium attached with calyx, and that's the reason it is called epipetalous. Okay. Epi means the upper part of the androecium is attached with petal, so this is called epipetalous. Okay, next, when androecium attached with perianth, like perianth, and one thing is very interesting, that is C. Why we write the C before the A? Because corolla always present outer side of the androecium. That's the reason we write it down C before A. Okay, so now the same thing happened in case of perianth, because perianth also present before androecium. That's the reason we write it down before A. Okay, so here PA and underline over the P and A. So this symbol indicate the perianth attached with androecium. Okay, and this is also symbolized by PA through this. Okay, this type of androecium is called epiphyllous. Epiphyllous. Okay, this type of androecium is called epiphyllous. Next, we talk about when androecium attached with inner part, means when androecium attached with gynoecium, then it is called, and this picture is AG through underline over the AG. And other symbol is AG and underlined by this. Okay, so this symbol indicate it is androecium attached with gynoecium. Okay, and this type of symbol is called gynostagium. Gynostagium. Okay, so this type of structure present in case of calotropis. Okay, means akondu. So this type of structure present in calotropis. Yes. Okay, now next we talk about the symbolic structure about gynoecium. Okay, first of all, gynoecium indicated by G. Okay, gynoecium. Okay, gynoecium, and the unit membrane of gynoecium is called carpel. Okay, carpel. Okay, when gynoecium are two, this indicate by the two at the base, but gynoecium has three form. This may be superior, inferior, or semi inferior or semi superior. Okay, when this is superior, then gynoecium symbolized by this, means underline below the G. This is indicate gynoecium here carpels are two, but this is superior. Okay, this is superior. And when gynoecium, through this symbol, this indicate gynoecium carpel 2, but it is inferior. Okay, but when the gynoecium 2 present with this symbol, this indicate gynoecium present with two carpel, and this is semi or half inferior. Okay, आई होप दिस इज क्लियर टू यू, बिकॉज दिस इज द होल फ्लोरल फॉर्मूला दैट आर ऑल द सिम्बॉलिक स्ट्रक्चर, एंड यूजिंग दिस सिम्बॉल वी ड्रॉ द फ्लोरल फॉर्मूला इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट.